हेलो डियर फ्रेंड्स, माई सेल्फ प्रोफेसर खोडदे ऋषिकेश एंड आई वेलकम यू ऑल इन चैनल बीएससी स्टडीज। सो इन दिस चैनल वी डिस्कस अबाउट वेरियस क्लासेस लेक्चर्स। टुडे आई एम स्टैंडिंग हियर टू एक्सप्लेन TYBSC पेपर नंबर 3 अबाउट जेनेटिक सिलेबस। सो ऑन द स्क्रीन देर आर वेरियस पॉइंट्स आर मेंशन इन यूनिवर्सिटी सिलेबस फॉर TYBSC। वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट चैप्टर बाय चैप्टर। टुडे I will be discussing here the first chapter, that is a basic introduction to the genetics. So let's begin with this chapter. So friends, we have to simplify this subject because the words in this paper or subject are very much tedious, or students find them difficult to understand or to remember these things. But let me tell you that the genetics is one of the easy subject, and after getting mastery in genetics, you will get mastery in various subject also. That is the motto of the introductory chapter of this genetic first chapter. So whenever we study genetics, we just not study genetics as its own. We study genetics with relationship with the other field also, such as the medical science, biotechnology science, biochemistry field, biotechnology field, molecular biology field. So I am talking here that the interrelationship of genetics with the other disciplinaries of the science. Disciplinary means the subject. So when we talk about national or international, national means the things which happen in the country. International means the things happen between the country. Likewise, interdisciplinary means wherever the connection is between the different branches of science or different branches of disciplinaries. Okay, so things are easy, that the genetic study is in relationship with the other fields of science. That is interdisciplinary approach. Whatever I have highlighted, that the genetic relationship with the biotechnology, where in biotechnology we are interested to find out particular location of gene, isolation of that gene and use of that gene for our human perspective. For example, the gene insulin is required for diabetic patient. The diabetic patient in which the insulin gene generally does not work. So we give the product of insulin by preparing the product in laboratory and insert the product in that person. But first, how we have understood the location of gene? So the genetic and biotechnology goes hand in hand with respect to the study of the particular type of gene. So it was just an example. So there are various examples, such as molecular biology. We are talking about the another field, that is molecular biology. We have discussed about biotechnology. We have moved to the another disciplinary, that is molecular biology. In molecular biology, we study about the expression of gene, in which we see the genes are located in nucleus. They produce their copy, which is temporary, which is known as RNA. And by using that copy, the cells produce different types of proteins. So this also comes under the molecular study, molecular biology study, but it is has a relationship with the genetics. So here I am trying to tell you the interdisciplinary approach of genetics with different subjects. So first of all, you will say, what will be the definition of this genetics? Genetics includes the study the hereditary characters which are transmitted from the parent generation to the next generation. Or we can say that the genes which are located in the DNA of each cell has the capacity to go into the next generation. So the genetic studies that how these genes transmission from one generation to the next generation, means from parent generation to the offspring generation, is included in the genetics. For this purpose, we are going to study. Once again, I would like to show you your syllabus. They have given you the Mendelism. Mendelism means the Mendel scientist have studied extensively about this genetics and find out the relationship of statistical in gene expression point of view. So I will not make it very hard to understand. First of all, I would like to tell you that this subject is are very easy. In this chapter, we are discussing about just introduction of genetics, interrelationship of genetics with other subjects, and the definition of genetics. So definition means where we study about the hereditary nature or hereditary of particular expression of gene. So friends, you all are aware about the word gene. So what is these genes are actually? Everyone, if you look at any organism, for example human being, you will find there are various characters present in that human being. The characters such as the height of human being, the color of hair of human being, the texture of hair, whether it is curly or straight, the eyes pattern, the color of eye, the structure of nose, all these things I am saying here are the characteristic of that particular human being, which is nothing but one organism. So the genes which are present in the cell, in the DNA, are designed in such a way that each gene control one character. Sometime many genes are required to control one character. So the genes are responsible for character. So it is clear up to you now. So if you take one character such as height, height is one character. If you talk about height, the person may be dwarf or person may be heighted. So what are these? These are the form of the character of height. Dwarf is one form of that character and tallness is another form of that character. So when we talk about gene is responsible for character and character has a forms, so what is this actually? The human being contain two copies for each gene in their every cell. Why only two copies? Because every human being arises due to the two parents, mother and father. Mother gives one copy and father gives one copy of each gene. So we have two copies for each gene. In genetics, these copies are known as alleles. So we have two alleles for each gene. If genes are controlling the character, alleles are responsible for the form of character. Such as, if the alleles are dominant, means both copies you have got are dominant, then the character expression will be the tall, because we are talking about the expression of that gene with respect to the character in human being for the character of tallness, okay, or character of height. So don't get too much confused. Here I am talking about the genes and alleles, characters and forms. The words are given in genetics to show you the genes are responsible for characters and alleles are responsible for the form of that character. So if you get two copies of gene which are recessive, obviously that person is going to be dwarf. Okay, so it must be the clear up to you that gene and allele and character and form. So all these things are included in genetics. So here I am talking about the introductory fashion of genetics, how these genetics are designed in such a way that it has relationship with other subjects also. So the concept of hereditary includes the transmission of character from one generation to the next generation with the help of genes. Means by sending the gene from one generation to the next generation, we are sending the character from one generation to the next generation. It is as detailed as I am talking here. Because when we say we are sending one gene from one generation to the next generation, human being or any organism cannot send the single gene directly. For that, the organism need to have sexual reproduction, in which when gametes of male and female comes together, get united and form zygote, this zygote is result into the new generation. So the gametes from old generation result into the zygote, which is new generation. This gametes carries the gene. So I am sure it is clear up to you now, that how genes are transmitted from one generation to the next generation, that is hereditary. So in hereditary, you will find there is a variation in new generation morphology. What it means that you have sister and brothers. You all look different somehow to each other. Why it happens? Because in sexual reproduction, these alleles or chromosomes shows some changes while formation of gametes. Why it happens? It's the point of discussion in later chapters. But just remember that the new generation will show the morphological differences. It is due to the differences, somewhat little differences of the gamete containing genes which are transmitting from one generation to the next generation. So when we talk about the application point of view of genetics, remember or recall whatever we have discussed about the interdisciplinary approach of genetics with the other subjects. So the application will comes in front of us when we study the relationship of genetics with the other subjects. So I am sure you must have understood the basic of the genetics. I have just discussed a little in this genetics topic because this is just the first chapter in which you will get the introductory point of view of genetics. As shown in the syllabus, the next chapter will be the Mendelism study in which Mendel have performed some mathematical or statistical expression in which he has shown that genes shows particular pattern of expression all time because it is a fixed format in which genes are expressed. You will come to know the detail about what I am talking here by watching the next video of on the basis of this chapter. So I am sure you will enjoy this genetic subject and it will help you to understand the complex concept which are based on the genetics. Thank you very much for giving your time to watch this lecture. We will meet in next lecture with a new topic. And don't forget to subscribe this channel and click on the bell icon so you will get the notification. Take care. Bye.